Chris Lovett and I discuss the Colts' outlook for the upcoming season after they've acquired Carson Wentz. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more NFL videos.
So the big news yesterday, of course, was that Carson Wentz finally, after some weeks of rumors, had been traded to the Indianapolis Colts for only a third-round pick this year and a second-round pick next year. But that one obviously could become a first-round pick if Wentz plays 75% of the snaps, which, to be honest, that's probably going to happen. So you as a Colts fan, obviously, what was your reaction to that trade?
Well, in the kind of weeks leading up to this, I really wasn't too keen on getting Wentz. I mean, I kind of saw how he played last year and I kind of talked myself into, you know, thinking that this would not be a very good move for the Colts. But the longer that I'm thinking about it, I mean, I'm starting to like it more and more. It's a trade that could end up being like a huge win for the Colts. I mean, if you can get a franchise quarterback who's proven that he can play at a higher level in this league, he's obviously also proven he can play at a fairly low level as well. But if Wentz can regain that 2017 form where he was an MVP candidate, I think this is a steal. Obviously, there's the reverse of that. You know, if he plays like he played last year, then maybe that's slightly overpaying for him. But yeah, it's a bit of a strange trade because it's not often you see a trade from a guy who's been in the league for 5 years and he's still a bit of an unknown commodity. I mean, normally you would know exactly what it is that you're trading for when, like I say, he's been in the league for 5 years. But I guess you don't really know which Wentz you're going to get. But the one thing I would say is this is like the ideal situation for Wentz, and there's going to be a lot of pressure on him this year because he's got a great O-line, he's got a coach he likes, he's got good weapons and a top 10 defense. I mean, there's really no excuse for him here. I think this is kind of, you know, boom or bust for Wentz this year.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it depends kind of on how, like, which version of Wentz you're going to get. 2020 version where he was first in interceptions and sacks, despite like having four fewer games than everyone else. And, or like you said, the 2017 version where he was kind of the MVP candidate. And with Frank Reich as his OC back then, he had 33 touchdowns and got up to 11 wins. So that's certainly something to consider. And yeah, I think it is kind of a steal that you didn't really have to give up a first round pick. Like, you're going to end up giving up that first round pick probably next year, because unless he's going to get an injury, which you wouldn't want, he will play 75% of the snaps. So, but obviously then you still have that big contract kind of that will go over to the Colts, which is $128 million. Kind of, that's a big hit. But yeah, I think, like you said, he really doesn't have any excuses now. He's going to have a great running game, very good offensive line, and the coach that he was most kind of comfortable with. So you think that kind of catapults the Colts into kind of a serious Super Bowl contender for next year?
Yeah, for sure. And just one quick note about the contract. It looks quite big on paper, but it averages out to less than $25 million a year over the next 4 years. And when you consider the Colts were paying Philip Rivers $25 million last year, Wentz is actually, you know, slightly cheaper than Rivers. And because the Eagles ate so much of the dead cap, the Colts can cut Wentz before the 1st of June next year with no cap hits at all. So they can cut him and get him completely off the books for no hit. They would only have to pay the $25 million he's due next year. So yeah, it's obviously, you know, quite easy to get out of if it does turn into the 2020 Wentz again. But yeah, just to touch on the Colts, I mean, this looked like a team last year that was missing an X factor at quarterback, and maybe not even an X factor, maybe just some good quarterback play. We saw it in patches from Rivers, but again, when you consider everything that's there already, I mean, this is a perfect situation for a quarterback to go in. And last year, it looked like the Colts were missing that quarterback. So, yeah, I would definitely say this puts the Colts as one of the top five teams in AFC. I don't think there will be too much argument about that. But whether, you know, Wentz really can put them over the top into real Super Bowl contenders, I think that does remain to be seen.
Yeah, I mean, the only thing that worries me a bit was, of course, the high numbers of turnovers that Wentz had over the past few years. That kind of worries me for the Colts because Philip Rivers was very kind of fairly good with his like turnover ratio this year. That could be kind of the only negative I see at the moment in case of the four that speaks against the Colts being like Super Bowl contenders next year. But I think if like yeah, they have a great defense, they have a like a good running game, probably the almost the best offensive line there is. If they can replace Costanzo as their left tackle, which they can now do obviously with their first round pick this year. So yeah, I think the Colts are definitely a team to watch next season.
Yeah, and I think just one other point. I mean, for the Colts, it was either going to be, you know, Wentz, Darnold, or a rookie quarterback. And if you think what the Colts would have had to give up to move up from 21 into the top 10, maybe even the top 5 to get their franchise quarterback, you know, you're looking at multiple firsts, maybe even slightly more than that. So I think to address the QB problem with just a third this year and a conditional second first next year. And then obviously to be able to use those picks to address other needs. I think this was great from Chris Ballard. And yeah, I think it's an exciting year to be a Colts fan, and we'll have to see which Wentz turns up.